Hello, and welcome back to Ramayan Review, where we are going through the old Boggle Ramayan contests from this year, 2022. Now we're on round 2, we've gotten fairly far through, almost done, and we stopped the last one in the middle of doing the second Boggle. I didn't want to skip it just because it seems like I'm on the right track, and so I didn't want to end it without, you know, giving it a real try. One thought I've had is, you know, the way we were able to get this call was because there were 6 letters that it needed to be touching, and it can't touch 6 letters when it's on that. So the only place it could be was right there, because it needed to be touching the W. The thought I had was, if you're along the edge, one of your 5 letters needs to be one of the letters that's already there. But, kind of trying to build off of the O, if we look at the R here, and just kind of write it out, so you gotta go from W to O to R. So R is somewhere around here. And the letters R needs to be next to is G, G, I, from grid, B, from timer, and then O and D. So G, I, E, O, D. None of those letters are one of the given ones. So if I were to have R here or here, I could have G, I, D, O, but no E. So I believe R also has to be in the middle here. Where exactly? Not really sure. D unfortunately only appears at the start or the end of words. So D needs to be close to O, I, and R. I is up here. R is in here. So if it needs to be close to I, R, and O, like here, I suppose it would be close to O, I, and if that was R, that would be the R. What about I? I, we got grid, so R, D, and then timer. Yeah. So T, obviously, we've already got that. And then RDM. T. I don't think I can be here. So if M is there, I can't be close to R. So here, I, then we got T, R, M, and then D. And if I was here, we would have R, M, and then D. But D is equals to O, I, and R. So I, R, and M. O, I, I wouldn't be able to do that. I think if that were I would then have to have M and R down here, because those are definitely in the middle here. The vowels are just one possibility, but M and R definitely have to be in this middle square. So if that were my I, I would have M and R down here, and then I wouldn't be able to place the D to be able to touch everything it needs to. So I don't think that's I. I believe I ruled that out to be I, because it's touching O, whatever. It's touching D. And it can only touch either M or R, but not both. So I think this is I here. And we've got MR here, so we can do the U. Just put E back there. I don't know if that is an E, but it's one of the possibilities. So I, MR, and D. And D needs to touch I, O, and R. So E, I, O, R? R, M? Maybe. D, O, M, E. W, O, R, D. I mean, it doesn't mean but much, but I can cross word out. We've got that in here now. D O M E somewhere. T I M E R or E R. Because there are two E's. I've got my two M's now. So I didn't need that. I don't have either of the E's or either of the G's. But I do have R, I, D. So G needs to be in one of these two. B and G. And B and G need to be touching. Right? No. B and L. Right, B and L need to be touching, not B and G. J, U, U, M, and then B, L, E. O. Right, wherever the G needs to be next to O. So G, I think, is here. And change that back to just U. So now we've got GRID. So there's grid done. O, G, G, L. E, M, B, L, E. A, U, M, E. I feel like maybe I might just be able to B, L, E. But the B needs to be next to the L. Cool. I hope this doesn't just completely screw me over. The B needs to be over here. B, M, E. Both of the M's need to be next to an E. So I've got two E's down here. Well, I would have two E's down here. B needs to be next to the O. B, O, G, G. No. D has everything it needs to be close to right there. R. So there's only one R. So that would have to be the E to make timer work. Okay, so then this would have to be U. But then this would have to be J-U-M-B. Is this G correct? Maybe not. It's causing a lot of issues. ER or ER? If I do still have ER like that, now the J, U, M, B needs to be next to O, L, E, either way, I'd be able to make M1. So then that would leave the two G's going here. E-O-G-G-L-E. Let's see. Let's find out. So we'll get rid of that and just go down. So B-O-G-G-L-E. Awesome. B-O-M-E-A-N-E. Good. E-M-B-L-E-M. Perfect. G-R-I-B. Good. Didn't even consider going up there like that. J-U-M-B-L-E. Fantastic. T-I-M-E-R. Good. W-O-R-D. Alright. That gives us W-G-L-M, GOB, and T-A-H. Let's go. 17 points. Not that it matters now, but... I mean, I don't know if you've been kind of keeping track of how many points everything's worth. Something worth 17 is a little crazy. Like, if we just go to maybe, like, Touching Shapes 3, this was worth 5 points. So, I mean, that gives you just a little bit of a clue as to just how insane that Boggle was. Anyway, on to Scrabble. If you know the rules of Scrabble, you basically know how this puzzle's gonna go. We need to place all the listed words exactly once in the grid going across, left, right, or down, and top to bottom. Each word intersects with at least one other word, and all words are interconnected. No words of two or more letters can appear anywhere in the grid, except the ones listed. There cannot be any letters in the shaded cells, if there are shaded cells. Some letters may already be given. So, we're on our first Scrabble. We've got our 6 words down here we need to put in. And we got 2 fairly long ones. 4, 8. Yeah, both 8 long. And the grid is 8 long. So these 2, at least, will have to go all the way across. So if I had Clueless at the top, and Scrabble at the bottom, we could put clues like that. Because that also needs, well, if it goes down, it would need to span the whole thing. Letter. It's 5. So letter would also need going horizontally. But then clues, let, and steal could go either direction. I'm trying to kind of get these placed in my mind. So, like, I think if I had clueless up here, there would only be one place to put clues. Like, if I had a clueless up here, there'd only be one way to put in clues. Then there's only one way to put in Scrabble. But then, to put in letter, I wouldn't necessarily need to use that. So, I don't know, let's take a look. Scrabble. So I was thinking, if I was going to put in letter, I would have to go here, which just would not work. But it doesn't have to go here. Just as long as it combines, it can go here. In fact, I see I can put steel there. And that kind of makes a good match for letter. And you can slip let right there. So there we go. Clueless, clues, let, letter, Scrabble, steel. And so then, enter the letters in the mark those columns, ignore other empty cells. So A, we've got L-E-T, B, we've got U letter, and C, we've got let B. Let, U letter, let B. And there we go. The Scrabble one was worth only 2 points. And so now, Scrabble 2. Much larger. And we've got some given letters this time. So, I like to look for the longest words because those seem to be the most forced, usually. For instance, challenge. Like, I mean, it almost perfectly slots in right here. C-H-A-L-L-E-N-G-E. So, like, why wouldn't you do that? It might be like a red herring. Ooh, look at this. Challenge goes right there. I like music. Well, we've got BLE here. That could be double. It could be Scrabble. What about this 10? Extension. That's the only thing. And Chion. Okay. Now this E then needs to end the word here, because it can't go there. In fact, you know what? Let's make it a little more pencil puzzle. So those are out. Those cells. So this E, S-C-O-R-E, score seems nice, T, no, there's an S. so I think that's really all it could be. Score. And there we go. Score is done. S-C-R-A-B-B-L. So yeah, this can't be double anymore. Scrabble. Keep that out. And I've got a D-O here. if we could handle it for double. There we go. That's out. FSG here. Bingo. Let's change. Can't be bingo here. So it looks like exchange is what it's gonna be part of. There we go. Now we've got 5 words left. None are 3 letters long. We've got this R to use. It's not in letter. Words, either across or down, would work out. But then it would need to connect. Where would be a good place to put letter? E-T-T-E-R, no. No, E-T-T, no. I think letter is gonna go, I guess, somewhere up here, maybe like down in some fashion. Bingo blank? Blank. What about this L? Can't be part of letter. Can't be part of triple. E-R-I, and then put the P in before it. Okay. So these are not combined. Actually, maybe they are T-R-I-E-L-E. See what that does for me. Triple. And I would also be able to do words this way. Words, triple. So triple and words. So letter, bingo, blank. B-I-N-G-O. Bingo could go right there. Blank could go there. In fact, I could have blank and then bingo going down. And then all that's left is to find a place to slot in the letter. Which might be a problem. I kind of like blank bingo over in this corner. I wouldn't have been able to put letter down here anyway, so that's okay. Letter. Not seeing a place to put it. Which makes me think maybe this triple is incorrect. L-E-T-T-E-R, and I wouldn't be able to put letter there. The only place letter can go right now is like up here. L-E-T-T-E-R. Sure, but that's no, that's nothing. I wouldn't be able to put score here. Where in the world does letter go? I really hope I'm not just overlooking something that's super obvious. We couldn't go down there and run into the B and the F. I mean, it could have gone here. But that just seems like it blows up this entire side, and then where does challenge go? I don't want to start the whole thing over with that thought. Like, it would leave extension and double there. Those would stay. But then, like, this B and the E could be combined. The C could still be used in exchange. But again, more than challenge. If I got rid of that, put letter in here. Is there somewhere else I could put words? Yes. Words. So there we go. Oops. Let's just take a look. Blank. Got it. Bingo. Challenge. Double. Exchange. Extension. Letter. Score, Scrabble, triple, works. So the answer here would be C letter, bingo, D-O-A-K. C letter, bingo, D-O-A-K. There we go. Now unfortunately, I believe that's the time for this episode, so we're going to literally be one puzzle away from finishing this set. But we'll do that, and maybe we'll take a peek at what round 3 is going to hold for us in the next episode. If you like this episode, hit like. If you like my commentary or puzzle solving, hit subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one. So long.